What's going on, Louie crew? We are back with another YouTube video, finally. Thank you all so much for sticking around. And in today's video, we're going to be breaking down my top 5 TikTok posts so far this year in 2020. This is based on, you know, view count, likes, comments, just overall engagement, the ones people keep asking me about if I'm going to make it into a full single or not. So without further ado, let's just jump right into this shit. This was my very first post to blow up.
Welcome to your
State of the App address, baby.
Brought to you by Louie Capone.
Yo, when I first came out with this post, I was such a nobody. I had like maybe 30 or so followers. And everybody thought it wasn't my sound. Like, there was a bunch of comments down below, like, imagine thinking this is your sound with the clown face. And I was like, bitch, it literally says my name in the intro. And that old timey voice guy intro, it literally says Louie Capone. Like, trust me, I just make content. Chill, bro. I'm not trying to steal shit. Jesus. Let's continue.
To material that might trigger you, now would be the best time to move along.
Welcome to your State of the App address. For those who haven't used the app before, it's for the best. I can guarantee the moderators really can on a test that we got ladies showing just a little more of their chest than they would ask for, and we got more fake fights than a video gamer's dashboard. And there's dudes like me who often post scarcely, and yet we get a fucking flag because we violated the policy. I don't have my fucking tits hanging out. I know I should probably throw my ass around and about, and I guarantee my ass could really give me some clout, or maybe military services, which y'all are about. I don't know, there's so many little things that I could fucking choose from. Don't you just love it? Don't it make you just wanna do something? Keep us some teeth like a game of fucking chess. Hope you all enjoy this with your State of the App address. Hell yeah. Yeah, that was fucking dope. Shout out Shirazi for the amazing beats at all times, bro. Y'all go, if y'all are looking for beats, go check out Shirazi. Like, an absolute legend. Let's see what else we got. What else we got?
Ladies
oh, yeah.
and gentlemen, welcome
we got
to
the part two now.
State of the App address.
That actually was Tito's Oil and Water.
Fuck it. Fuck you.
Yeah. Welcome to your State of the App address. I thought I'd never use the app, but now I haven't left. And now I think it's time that I confess. I used to poke fun, but I'm grinding like the rest.
Aren't we all like that? We all start TikTok as like, bro, this is the most cringy piece of shit app. It's just a bunch of underage girls dancing. And then you get on there and all of a sudden you're hooked and there's no escaping. And there's no escaping. You have to quit before you start. Otherwise, you're doomed. Moving on.
Moderator still blind to a bare chest. Honestly, I don't think that I could care less. But what gets me feeling all pissy is people going viral over nothing. I'm impressed. Rioting and violence. We got hella ass. We got perky tits. The content's borderline fraudulent. But ain't nobody give a fuck about what's the difference. Ain't no matter what it's...
Yo, when I was writing that in, that fraudulent voiceover, I know that I messed up in the recording. And so I dubbed over it, but I thought I dubbed over it well enough to where you wouldn't be able to tell, but I was wrong. And so whenever I was going in to write in the subtitles, it was very clear that it wasn't the right audio. And so I just on the fly was like, wait a minute, what if it went with the bar? What if I could make fun of myself dubbing over it in a way that fit with the bar itself? Anyway, I thought that was clever. I'm not sure if y'all picked up on that, but. Let's continue.
Just enough. All these boys act tough till their hands are cuffed. The girls all dance with a dusty muff, and now I'm fucking them up. They said they wanted it rough. And anybody's out there listening, if anybody's still social distancing, you might not catch it and be sniffling. But the vibe I describe here is sickening.
Oh, big old chug. I remember the pain that it took, that I experienced making that. Wouldn't make a video like that again. That was tough. Oh, yeah. This is one y'all have really wanted me to make into a full song. I get a lot of requests for this one. Oh, and another thing, real quick. Let me pause. You guys very astutely observed that that was not my voicemail. And you were correct. That is not my voicemail. That is a voicemail that came with the beat that I was using. But of course, you know, for a little more production value, a little more, theatrical glory, I decided to hold up my phone and make the experience more immersive. You know what I mean? Does that make sense? Is that okay? Is that okay that I did that? I didn't openly claim that it was my voicemail. Okay? Just something to think about. Let's continue.
Yeah.
Let me take a minute real quick. Don't call back cause you're dying for dick. Promise that I'm dumb when I say that I quit. We're together for a year, now you think I'm a simp? Don't even act shocked that we broke up, bitch. No pity points here, quivering your lower lip. You're looking for some love, I'ma give a little tip. Call one of the guys that you hooked up with. You're looking for the boyfriend, Louis, not me. You were murdering his heart with these slutty outings. Now that you found out that without me you're drowning, I hope you sink fast and your heartbeat is pounding. Cause you won't be around me. I ain't gonna answer when your demons are surrounding. Then you'll get the feeling I was having. You sent a fucking message and believe me, it's resounding. You ain't worth my time. You ain't worth a dollar, not a motherfucking dime. With the wealth that I grind out, a little girl crying, sitting in timeout. Always being childish, you thought I wouldn't find out? Fuck you. You Dyson vacuum, cyclone technology for a mouth, have an ass bitch.
Yo, that ending is probably the only reason that blew up. I think it has like 1.5 million on TikTok right now. And dude, my family, I didn't know they followed me on TikTok. They were like calling me, asking me if I was okay, like if my mental state was all right. Because if you know me personally, you know I'm not a very, what's the word? I'm not violent. I'm not aggressive. Bitch, it literally says my name in the intro. I'm not a very aggressive dude. And there's no escaping. You have to quit before you start. You know, I was in the Marine Corps Infantry, but that doesn't mean I'm an aggressive dude. You know what I mean? So yeah, that got me a lot of heat from my family. It was based on a true story though, so fuck that hoe. Moving on. Oh boy, the one that made it all happen.
Let's go, weebs out there.
Oh God, yo, this couldn't be hotter. Don't hate, yo, you really don't gotta. One bar and I'm ending all the drama. Punchlines hitting like Saitama. You're a titan, I wonder who's next. Slicing the neck like I did to the rest. Top of the team in the scout regiment. You really want it, then prepare to get bent. You're the Uchiha, I am Itachi. Only another Sharingan gun can stop me. I am the original, you are a copy. Shatter clone Jutsu, but yours looking floppy. Japanese gives you a little bit of practice. Watch one show, but I couldn't quite crack it. Full metal looking pretty fucking savage. And if you disagree, catch this full metal jacket. All talk, but this really okay though. Wanna settle that, let's hop on SAO. Ty Lee got me acting so loco. But I'm I roll when I'm spitting that fuego. Dude, come on. What do I even need to say about that one, bro? Holy shit. Yo, when I made that, I was not expecting it to be my number one most liked video of all time. I was like, dude, anime is a huge, huge culture. A lot of people are into it. Hip-hop, rap is also a huge thing that a lot of people are into. But think about how many people are into anime and rap. It seems like those two kind of niches wouldn't really work well together, but I was completely wrong, obviously. And whenever I made it into a full single, it hit a million streams in a month, and I feel like I bring that up every chance I can because it's fucking awesome. Yeah, by far my most proud collaboration of cultures there. That was awesome. Yeah, thank you guys so much for the love on that one.
All right, you guys, today we're doing Godzilla,
but this time we're gonna try to do
both of the fast rapping verses.
Everyone always asked me if this was real, or if I like cut it somehow or edited it, but this is 100% legit. I remember I did like Navy SEAL breath training to be able to have a larger lung capacity and require less oxygen, just so I could pull this off. Like, it took at least a couple hours of preparation and trials to get this right. And so the fact, I'm really thankful that it did well with views and stuff, because it took a lot.
This is with only one breath.
Let's watch, so. Trappy, packy, but it's black ink, evil half of the bad meets evil. That means take a backseat, take a back to fat beats. What a maxi, single look at my rap sheet. What a track seat, spiegel, this my gangsta bitch like Apache. What a catchy jingle, I stack chips, you barely got a happy. I held my nose to prove that I wasn't breathing. Fill him with the venom and eliminate him. Otherwise, I'm in him, I don't want to hurt him, but I did him in a fit of rage. I'm murdering him, nobody will have been a kill him. And double the fucking bodies in like obliterating. Everything is incinerated, renegade, man, make anybody who want it with a pen and frame. Nobody want it, but they're gonna get it anyway. Cause I'm beginning to feel like I'm mentally ill until the killer be killing, kill be the vanilla gorilla. You're gonna kill him with an idiot. You don't want to be the enemy of the demon who enemy of being the sick enemy. What's the big enemy? Everybody's the epitome. You're spinning when I'm in the vicinity. Motherfucker, you better duck me. You finna be dead. The minute you're running to me 100%. You is a fifth of a percent of me. I'm about to fucking finish you, bitch. I'm available. You wanna battle? I'm available. I'm blowing up like inflatable. I'm undebatable. I'm unavoidable. I'm unavoidable. I'm controllable. I got a trailer full of money and I'm paid it full. I'm not afraid to pull them.
Man, stop.
Man, stop.
Look what I'm planning.
Jesus. Ouch. And yeah, that about wraps up our top five. I think that was five. Top five TikTok posts. We got more coming, of course. You know, still got a couple months left. in the year. So y'all be looking out for the future ones. Thank y'all so much again for tuning in, for all the love on all my music, all my posts, everything. Y'all go follow me on Instagram, TikTok if you want to see more videos like this. And until next time, take it easy, Louie crew. I'm out of here.